Elsa, thank you very much for giving up your time today. It's a very difficult time for us and a challenging time across the world. So I really appreciate you being here with us. Now, you've been through some difficult times yourself. Can you talk to us a little bit about these?
Well, Anna and I have gone through some really difficult times. We've lost our parents and we've gone on many difficult journeys together. But we've learned some really valuable things. You know, we've learned how to stay positive and how to really work together and overcome those difficult challenges.
I know that you are originally having to hide your magic powers. Why would you want to be in a situation where you had to hide your powers? Can you explain a little bit about that?
I felt I needed to isolate myself. I was worried I was going to hurt other people or that other people were going to hurt me, so it was the right thing to do to stay hidden.
So you were having some negative thoughts, is that right?
Yeah.
How did you learn to overcome these negative thoughts? What did you do? What did you say to yourself?
I learned to embrace myself. I became my authentic, true self, and I learned to completely embody everything that I was capable of.
And I wonder, the song Let It Go, which is now a classic song, is that a little bit about you kind of becoming your true, authentic self, would you say?
Absolutely.
We would really love you to sing that song. Would that be okay?
Of
would you
course.
Like to sing that for us? Okay, I'll get out of your way. Thank you.
Thank you.
That was amazing, Elsa. Thank you very much. That was awesome. Now, you obviously then became more mindful of your emotions. You learned to regulate and control your emotions. You became a little bit happier about who you are as a person. And you did heal Anna with your love. So that was a beautiful expression of that. Now, I have some questions from some of the Penrhos girls, if you don't mind.
Absolutely.
Okay? Excellent questions. Some of them hard, so just a bit of a heads up. Okay. All right, we'll see how we go. Victoria Kindy says, how could you come here with COVID-19 around?
Well, it was a bit of a challenge, but Mr. Revit was kind enough to let me stay with him. He really wanted me to come visit you guys, and I really wanted to come and share the love, and they opened up the borders so that I could sneak through and see you as well.
So I treat you like one of my daughters in a way.
Yes,
that'd be fair
do.
To say?
Yeah.
Yeah, online shopping, yeah. Things like that.
Fantastic. Oh, well, sometimes.
Fantastic. Okay. Arissa and Emily want to know, why do you have magic powers?
Oh, well, see, I only recently discovered that myself. I travel to the magical forest where the Nathalja people live, and they're magical, and they have a brilliant connection to the land. So my mother came from them, and that's how I got my magical powers. My sister Anna, however, is more related to my father, the King of Arendelle, who doesn't have any magical powers, and that's why she doesn't either.
Fantastic, thank you. Now, Maria from Year 2 is a huge fan, and she's got a really interesting question. She says, what did you feel when you had to take the Earth Giants to the bridge to do the right thing? How did you feel about that?
Well, Anna was the one who actually did that, and she spoke to me about that, and she said that she was really scared, and she was frightened, and she knew that she had to be brave and do the next right thing to make sure that she could help everyone that she loved.
Fantastic. Now, Savannah from Year 2 says, and this is a great question, what do you love about Orloff?
Oh, absolutely everything. His joy, his positivity. He will always put a smile on your face.
He is pretty amazing. And in Frozen 2, he is hilarious.
Oh, he's so funny.
He must have had you all laughing on set all
really
the time. He's non-stop. He is
absolutely
fantastic. Brilliant. Okay. So, in Frozen 2, you do go into the unknown. You sing about not knowing where you're meant to be. And you feel like you don't really belong anywhere, and you feel a great deal of sadness. Is that right?
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about what that sadness was like, and what was sort of causing that?
Well, I knew I was really loved by all of the people around me, but I felt that I didn't have a place where I could fit in. I felt like I wasn't being my true self, and I had to go find who I was.
You do seem different to the other Disney princesses. Snow White whistles while she works. Ariel flips her fins, Rapunzel likes craft work, Cinderella scrubs floors. But you really look out and you can feel that, and you say the winds are restless. You are anxious for humankind. You have to self-isolate, a little bit like we're having to do now, and you're worried about the expectations on you. And would it be fair to say at times you found it hard to be happy? So you're not really kind of blindly optimistic and perky all the time like some Disney princesses. You say there's no escape from the storm inside of you. What are some tips you have for us to cope with self-isolation now? How did you deal with your worries?
Well, it was really difficult. It was really hard, and growing up as knowing I was going to have to be queen was a big challenge. So it meant that I had to grow quite quickly. And I think it's really important to make sure that you stay positive and you stay with the ones that love you, because they really support you, and it's really important to surround yourself with positivity and love.
So family and love are really important right now.
Absolutely.
And we need to care for each other. Now, you have to walk bravely into the unknown. There's a song about that. Would you
yes.
mind singing it for us?
Of course.
Thank you.
Everyone I've ever loved is here within these walls. Are you here to distract me so I make a big mistake? Or are you someone out there who's a little bit like me, who knows deep down I'm not where I'm meant to be? Every day's a little harder as I feel my power grow. Don't you know this part of me that longs to go into the unknown, into the unknown, into the unknown? Oh, are you out there? Do you know me? Can you feel me? Can you show me?
Song to sing, and you sang it beautifully. Thank you.
Thank you
very, very much. One last question really is about Anna, your sister. Her song about the next right thing shows a way out of sad and lonely times. It says you don't have to have all the answers. You just need to keep going and do the next right thing. What do you admire most about your sister Anna?
She is one of the bravest people I have ever met. She is so protective and selfless. And what I love about her is how she really is able to take a deep breath, look at what she needs to do next, and really regulate herself and her emotions and the things going on around her. She's really thorough and thought through, and she really does try her best to just do the next right thing and take it one step at a time.
That is wonderful advice for the times we find ourselves in now, isn't it?
Absolutely.
It's really to take one breath at a time, one day at a time, and do the next right thing. So your advice would be to keep caring for each other, love our families, be respectful, be kind to our families, and we'll get to the other side of this together.
Absolutely.
All right. That's great advice, Elsa. We've loved having you come in today.
It's been a pleasure.
It's been amazing. I hope you can come back one day.
I'll try my best.
Thank you very much. All right. Goodbye. Goodbye, everyone. Thank you.
Goodbye,
for
everyone.
In.
Thank you.